Hola, quiero español metal negro. Groove mal, por favor. That is my bad attempt to say that this is a Spanish black metal band called Cry Female minus E. I really cannot stop making this joke. It's Cry Female, but if you just would E add E there, it would be Cry Female. Not only the band name is rather horrible, this cover image is also rather horrible. To me, it looks like Abbath from Immortal and his own project Abbath has gotten a little bit weight here and is offering you his shovel.
Ah, this is Abbath. Want to dig your own grave? Well, here you have it.
All right, jokes aside, let's talk about the album in question called Eterna Obscuridad. So it's Spanish black metal that started its career in late 90s. And to be honest, I haven't been listening to the band since its second album in 2004, I think, when they released a really horrible album. And I guess since that, I haven't been hoping for to get to listen to this band anymore. Luckily, the band has improved during those 16 years a lot. And now this album is rather decent. It's like a time-lapse trip to 1990s, a kind of a trip when you feel like, okay, this is all about recycling Norwegian black metal ideas. Because I mean, those riffs, the kind of a sound also, vocals, everything is like overall like going back to the 90s. Well, to be honest, the vocals, which are kind of a screamy with effects, are not that good. Whereas versus the typical black metal band, doesn't matter which era, but they're doing their job just fine. Production could also be a lot better. I mean, it's not like raw and lo-fi and low budget like it was in the 90s if you went to, I don't know, Greek Holland Sound. But once you get kind of used to it, it doesn't really bother. Far from being good, quite tolerable. Now the music with this album is very much like fast tempo, but there are slower parts, and sometimes the bass guitar actually does some things. I mean, not just following the guitar leads or guitar riffs, but more like having life of its own, something that I really can totally respect and appreciate. Now, this thing with these 37 minutes of an album is that nothing really feels fresh, new, original, unique, and so forth. More like this is a good attempt to recycle some past ideas. And I don't mean anything bad by it, but because to be honest, I'd rather pick a good recycled album or album made of good recycled parts rather than anything new, avant-garde-ish, you know, having the originality for the sake of originality. Because sometimes when you try to do that as it's the main purpose of an album, it really goes bad and sinks to the sea or whatever. Now, whatever how it's pronounced, is a band that really doesn't, you know, get me going. It doesn't push all the right buttons, but it's pretty damn close to it. So even though I felt a little bit negative, feeling like this is once again one of those mediocre albums, after a few spins, I started to kind of warm up for this, and I'm like, okay, this is not bad. Actually, this is pretty decent. I kind of feel like there are these minor faults, rather than major flaws, could be fixed. I mean, a little bit better vocals, a little bit better production, maybe a little bit more kind of a bolder attempt. In terms of creating these songs, and that they would nail it. But now it's just like no cigar. It's not far away, but it's not really doing the trick. If you don't mind that at all, and if you're cool with just a decent black metal album, then this is definitely worth checking out. I think it's definitely worth checking out, even though it's not great. So go check it out. The whole album, or at least some samples of the songs, are on the Immortal Frost Bandcamp site. You will find those links in the description box, and there are also some other links related to the band which you might want to check out in case you're interested. If not, you can only blame yourself. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.